For the first time, folks, and there's probably nobody gonna watch this, but we'll see. We're just making some countertops, taking some countertops that I got as scrap, and I'm turning them into coffee tables. So it's gonna be a little wonky with all of this. But so I've got a whole bunch of slat. Whoop. Here we go. See what I said? So we got a whole bunch of slabs like this. I got a bunch in the backyard, you know, all different colors, shapes, and sizes. And we're going to cut them on the tile saw. I got a big 10-inch rigid tile saw. And then I've got different size legs. Most of them I got are like the 16-inch coffee table size, but I got a couple other different sizes. And I'm trying to adjust the camera. So we're gonna cut this one first. You see the saw? Yeah. Which one do I need to tighten? One of these I gotta tighten up. Let me see. That's that one. There it is. Alright, let's see. Are we good? Yeah, so we're gonna cut this. And I'm not gonna polish the edges. I'm gonna try to sell these on Facebook. I'm not gonna polish the edges though. Because that'll take a whole bunch of time, and these are, I'm trying to like make nice tables cheaply, so I'm not trying to make them cost a whole bunch of money. So I'm just gonna cut the bad edges off, and I am gonna clean them up though. So let's put this one. We'll see how long we can do this, but the baby's taking a nap, so that's kind of gonna determine how long I can do this for. Oh, I gotta plug it in. Womp womp. These are heavy, so I mean, this is a big saw, and I still gotta hold these on here, dude. I mean, look how pretty that is. And I get these scrap. These are from a countertop place that I know of that lets people just take all their junk. So, I mean, I literally could make... I'm trying to think of a number that's not exaggerating. Not exaggerating. I could probably make 100 of these, honestly. Like, really. Well, not probably. I definitely could make 100 of them with how much stuff they have out there. And, yeah. So I'm just gonna, I mean, that this one is beautiful. This one's quartz. Quartz is not a natural material. I actually just looked this up because I deal with countertops and putting countertops in. Let me get this going up without Batman. Here we go. All the time, and I really didn't know the difference with granite, quartz, marble. I mean, I know marble is, everyone knows marble is an actual stone, but quartz is just like is recycled stones from other products, and then they mix them together. There's one company that has I just looked this up today because I kept calling the customers quartz granite, and she kept correcting me because of how much she paid for the slab, and a little pretentious to correct some. I mean, literally, she probably corrected me on it at least 10 or 15 times. A little obnoxious, but so quartz is a it's not a natural material. It's from natural materials mostly. It's a it's leftovers from different stones and that kind of stuff. There's like metal in it in some of these, but then they like grind it down, and then they make this with a resin, and it's like 90, most of them is like 94% stone material. And there's a company that has a patent on most of it. Breton, and they do most of the companies, they make most of it. So anyways, so that's what quartz is. It's just a bunch of materials ground up and made into, and that's how you can see that it's ground up, and then put in a resin and then vacuum seal. So I'll show you what we're gonna do. We're just gonna on the bottom, and we're just gonna put legs on. How easy is that, huh? So, and if you really wanted to do this on your own, you could. You don't have to buy an $800 tile saw like I have. You can get, like, Ryobi makes, like, it's basically a circular saw with a water blade on it. And, I'm not going to sell these real expensive, like, well, I'm going to start off between like around 150 or 200, and if they sell fast, then I'll start raising the price, because obviously that means the market's good, and I can charge more. So I'm just going to mark these, how far in, doesn't really matter, you can do whatever you want, but I am going to do about an inch in. There. And yeah, this is kind of fun. This is an easy project. And if they don't sell, well, my family's gonna get some real nice tables for the holidays, and birthdays, and presents and whatnot. So they're probably hoping they don't sell. The idea kind of came from, I just passed the place and was interested, and I picked up one slab because it was so big. I was like, I can't pass this up. I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but I can't pass up this big slab. So So I took it home and was debating on what to do with it, and then decided it was like, oh, well, these can be outdoor tables because they're not going to get ruined, you know, from sun exposure. So why the heck not? So that's what I'm thinking I'm going to do with these. So I'm just marking for the holes right now. I can see all of them. Some of them it's hard to see because of the stone. Like blends in too good. There's one. There's one. Better make these a little bit more visible. And I got these legs on Amazon for, well, they differ in price based on length, but these short 16-inch ones are, I think, about $25. Got a bunch of these little cement bits, hammer bits, because they don't last long. It's about the right size, but I'm going to epoxy these in too, so they ain't going nowhere. Tape down here. Let me make this bigger, I guess. I don't know what you guys like. Tell me what you want. And my middle son are definitely under the weather. Not feeling the greatest. I'm gonna grab some tape for you. Yeah. Baby's asleep right now. I've got the baby monitor over there in the corner with the volume all the way up so I can hear him. He wakes up. Yeah, he's still sneezing. He didn't sleep good last night either. Bits to get hot, because that's when they wear out. If you can keep them cool, that's the trick. I just kind of forgot when we got started. I'm using a rigid drill on the hammer drill mode on here. They don't make this model anymore. This is an old drill. I would not recommend buying rigid stuff anymore. It's junk as far as I'm concerned. DeWalt, Makita, Milwaukee, those are your three best choices. Or if you're a homeowner, you could buy this stuff. It used to be good when I got these drills. Now the batteries and all the new tools are like crap. So Ryobi stuff is good, homeowner stuff. It's cheaper. And rigid also doesn't have as many tool options as the other DeWalt, Milwaukee, Makita, and Ryobi. Safety glasses, folks.
Yeah.
Alright, well, Wyatt just woke up, so I'm gonna go get him real quick. And, how do I pause this? I don't know if I can. Alright, well, I'm just gonna exit it and we'll do enough. I'll get back to it here shortly.